place first opened way back in 1957. We are inside legendary Lambeau Field here in Green Bay. Today, after a topsy-turvy opening weekend, it's on to week two, and we've got a good one here, as it'll be the Minnesota Vikings taking on the Green Bay Packers. Two clubs here, each looking to rebound from a week one loss as we're underway on EA Sports. And we'll see a return here from the end zone. And running with power here. And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25. They'll start on the ground here on first down. And he'll power ahead, but only for about 3 yards. Second down coming up. Hey, look at this defense for the Vikings. It's quite a unit, that's for sure. Number one in the NFL against the pass.
Normally you want teams to gel late in the season, but this unit, they've been terrific right from the word go. Came in as the number one rated unit against the pass in the NFL after just 1 week.
And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. 11 yards and a Green Bay Packer first down. Now look, that wasn't a huge gain, but those are the types of carries I think they were missing in their loss last week. They couldn't get him going on the ground.
Did you get the same feeling I did during our meetings, that they kind of regretted that he didn't touch the
Absolutely.
Ball? Absolutely. You know, hey, he should have touched it more last week. They weren't going to make that same mistake, and they've taken care of that early.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. On the counter, this is Moss. And he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up. The Packers had 0-1 on the year following the loss in the opener. And listen, they knew last week they were in for a tough fight on the road. But now here's the home opener and a chance to get things right.
And I like the way that you presented that, because the bottom line is they didn't come out of that loss discouraged. They just came home and said, hey, if we do what we're supposed to do, protect our home turf, we'll be just fine.
Second and six. One back in the backfield, he'll get the carry. And this one not going anywhere. They get him at the 44 for a gain of just a yard.
That's a really good job right there. Just kept stringing that play out, pushing him further and further towards the sideline. Really good fundamentals by that defense.
He was trying to put his foot in the ground and turn upfield. He just couldn't.
No, they really had a picket fence in front of him. No room to find to get upfield.
Third and five. Now Cooper looks to throw. And that is incomplete.
It certainly looked like someone was very confident in his ability to fit that one in. I would say he was overconfident, because there wasn't a whole lot of separation there. Had that one covered pretty well downfield and knocked it away.
And on fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one away. And this works out well, as it'll kick out of bounds at the 11-yard line. Second and six.
Well, at the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a four-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay, because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
Now a first throw of the afternoon, and the connection is there. And he'll take this across the 25 before going out of bounds. It's a gain of 11 as the Vikings pick up the first.
I'm about 99% sure this Packers dude isn't personnel matching and he's running Buda Baker at his slot. Or at his fucking sub linebacker. Yeah,
he is. He's probably on the next tier. But let me tell you something. If he becomes more consistent.
Into a double team and it's intercepted. And he'll take it across midfield and down to the 48-yard line. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape. He's like, oh, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
They'll run on first down with Marks. And they'll take this to the 46. Hey, look at this defense for the Vikings. They're currently sixth in the NFL in defending the run.
And this game for them is all about the line of scrimmage. Winning that battle, using their leverage, being the low man with power to take the offensive lineman and run them back into their own backfield and try and create some lost yardage plays.
Man, he's talking sword.
Touchdown. Christian Watson, his second touchdown on the season. And the Packers use the early turnover to get on the board first here in this one. Good start to the season for him. He had the touchdown last week in the opener and a second one in week two now.
How about the pace he's already established, right? Not sure he can keep it up for an entire season, but don't burst the bubble because he thinks that he can.
Do guys go into a season with a goal for touchdown score or yardage? What do you think?
I think every single one of the guys who's going to touch the football, they'll have those types of goals. They'll have those types of thoughts. Then they just have to see how the season unfolds if they can stay with it.
Unfolding so far so good for him. Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. But no run back here. Fair catch, and this will come out to the 25. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. They threw an interception the first time they had the football, wound up leading to a touchdown the other way. How do you approach drive number two?
Going back to your game plan coming in, everyone has matchups that they like better than others, where they think they have an advantage. Dial up some of those plays. Try and go to those spots and get your offense moving.
Well, they had the run for no gain. Now they'll try again from the 25 on second and 10. Meanwhile, the throw here is complete. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Jefferson has his first catch. He also has a first down.
And that's how you shake off the interception you throw on the opening drive, come back and throw another strike and gain nice yardage. And I give credit to two people on this one, the man throwing the ball and the person calling the plays. They're not shutting him down early in this game.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Now a handoff as they run left side. Breaks a tackle, narrow alley. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. That's good for 21 yards and a first down.
First down, Vikings.
They'll try and run this one right up the gut. And a missed tackle there as he pushes forward for a gain of four.
And that was a quality play to start a new set of downs. That was simply an offensive line winning the battle up front and winning in a big way and giving their guy in the backfield a nice lane to hit.
the 39-yard line. Here comes second down and six. Off play action. Bolden. But it's caught on the right side. It's Snow. So they'll get nothing out of that. It's the 33 on third down. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. That is incomplete.
Well, the gap man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
Will stay at a 7-point game.
Yeah, 55 yards is anything but a gimme. You've got to really concentrate on your leg swing and proper technique. This time, though, he's unable to convert.
About set to get this drive started, the Green Bay offense at the line.
Now, early on, you know, Charles, every game could be called a measuring stick game, but I think when it comes within your division like this, it's a measuring stick game with a little extra intrigue.
I would agree with that totally because all division.
I'm just letting you know there's a really high chance I'm not going to finish this fucking game against this Packers guy. He hasn't read the rules. I'm not going to fucking waste my time. Bro, he has fucking Buda Baker at linebacker. He hasn't personnel matched a single fucking time. Oh my. Not strafing. I play this shit.
A pretty nice throw right there from the rookie.
Take the fucking horse off. I don't give a fuck. I just don't want to waste my time with somebody clearly hasn't read the fucking rules.
In the opener, but what did you see from him last week?
Well, I think all things considered, he played pretty well, and I don't think I'd pin the loss on him. But there's no question, this is a learning process, and that was step one. And he's hoping on the road to glory.
Oh, he's good.
Lead this now 13-0 here in the opening quarter of the ball game. So after the disappointment in the opening week loss, Charles, this looks like really a completely different football team.
They sure do, and I think they realize we can't start 0-2, and they're determined to not let it happen by the looks of things here in the early going.
Crew able to connect on the extra point, and that'll make the score 13-0. Touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. They've been outplayed early, no question. Down 14-0 already as they come up first and 10.
He now subbed both of his fucking safeties into linebacker, so it's not just Buda.
But you're down early. How do you get back in the game? Maybe a step.
Bro, I'm not doing this. I'm not doing it.
On that one, and what I like about the message is that there's no panic from the head coach. He's already told his offensive coordinator.
It's PFC. Why would I fucking finish a game when he's not following the rules, man? I'll take the force loss. I don't give a fuck about that. I'm just not gonna waste my fucking time. He's coming out in quarters every single time.
He'll get the carry. And he'll manage to pick up about four. It's second down. Here we go. 14-0 the score. This is the NFL on EA Sports. The Vikings with the football here to begin the second quarter. As they are looking at a second down and six coming up.
Love being the test dummy for new users. It's so fun.
That's so fucking fun, dude.
Sideline throw, it's complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes in bounds. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down.
Let's make this one simple. What a catch, especially the finishing part of getting his feet in bounds, toe tapping.
That man has never heard of fucking matching personnel in his life.
Ooh, I like it.
And he'll get this into enemy territory, but not by much, as he's down to the 48. Tackle made there by Buda Baker.
Not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped them. Mark that down for a win in the defense's column.
Ready, set. From the 48-yard line, here's the second and nine.
Back to throw. Bolden trying to lay one up deep. Here's a diving catch right side. 39 yards there. A big one.
So often when we're watching a football game, we see one with a lot of...
Yeah, that was fucking stupid.
And sometimes, you just need a big play to...
Every time I throw it to you. Yeah, here we are. There's fucking Buda.
Shot of caffeine. This offense was
number three.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal.
Just trying to fucking play a game, man.
Pick up there down to about the nine. Only a yard that time. Second and goal. Defensively, pretty good start there with their backs against the wall.
That's a win for the stop troops right there. And if I'm them, I get a little bolder now. They won the first battle. Keep coming after them. Put the pressure on them.
To throw on second down. Bolden. There's Addison.
Man, that's so weird.
Vikings.
Man, that's so weird.
A 9-yard touchdown.
He took it so deep for no reason, man.
Cut it back within a score. And now, of course, all scoring plays are reviewed, and I think they're going to take an extra long look.
That's
at
me
this
feeding
one.
Addison so I can get a superstar dev.
So they called it a touchdown originally, and this will stay a touchdown after the video review, so they had it right. Extra point right down the middle, and that'll make our score 14-7. This game back within a touchdown now as the kickoff's away. And he'll very wisely take a knee here as they'll bring this one out to the 25 on the touchback. Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them. They feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go-around. They'll break the huddle, come up on second and eight at the 27-yard line. Here's Cooper. And that'll be incomplete. Well, he took a shot as he let that go. And it's going to bring up a third down.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go three and out here and give the football right back, because your friend, Old Momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side, and all of a sudden, you've got a battle on your hands.
So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves them staring up here at a third and eight. Well, everybody was up there ready at the line of scrimmage, CD, but no snap, and the delay of game ensued.
Yeah, and I'm sure their head coach is asking the exact same thing. What's going on out there? Almost like they thought they had more time than actually was on the clock.
After the delay, they're backed up even further for third and long. Cooper will look to throw it.
Yeah, that's true. My bad. Jesus fucking Christ, man.
That's what I mean about motherfuckers just don't play the ball.
So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up first and 10. They'll go up the middle here with Moss. And a 5-yard gain gets him to the 42.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage.
Looking to throw on second down. Cooper eluding the pressure right. Decision there, and it's going to be intercepted. Andrew Booth picks it off, and the Vikings are going to take over once again with a football at their own 20-yard line. Here are the Vikings now to start their next
three tight end quarters.
They'll start on the ground here on first down.
Fucking run the ball the rest of the game, man.
35 before going out of bounds. 66 yards rushing for him now, and he's carried the ball just 5 times. One play has him to the 37 here for first and 10.
Yeah, I know. It's been, that's what I'm saying, man.
One back in the backfield, he'll get the carry.
No, I just got to get my 10 throws in with fucking Bolden. Oh, he's going to come out in it. Don't worry.
A good gain again. That's now
he's just been doing
yards combined on those last two plays. We often give credit to the O-line. There, two tight end formation. Those tight ends block pretty well also.
Yeah, that's one of the most dynamic positions in football now. The tight ends who can block at the line of scrimmage at the point of attack.
Please. Also get downfield. Just get him.
Looking for more there on first down, but this throw downfield incomplete.
Early on, the running game's been working well. The
offense had him beat.
The thought process there, catch those safeties creeping up, trying to help against the running game. They tried to hit him over the top.
Should have Addison.
From the midfield strike, they'll look to throw. Complete to Addison on the out route.
No, my 10 throws.
So they're left with a third and three.
But appears that they hit man defense and went to the out route. And what you have to do in that one is the receiver's got to make sure he works the defender towards the middle of the field to give himself space to cut to the outside and have that ball delivered with good timing, and they get it done.
Yeah, this won't be enough. Stopped a yard short after a gain of 3, fourth down.
This team doesn't mind running the ball in any situation, and I thought he was going to get the first down the way the play developed. But the
not even a gambit, so I'm going
just
for this
about
shit.
A yard short.
Feeling like they're not quite in field goal range yet, they're going to go for it on fourth. They'll try and run for it. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37.
Okay, you and I are sitting up here getting ready to analyze whether they should go for it or not. Did you see the quarterback just point to the sideline and say, uh-uh, everybody back. I've got this call.
Well, you knew this side of the field, they're in plus territory, fourth and one. He wasn't coming off the field.
No, he wasn't coming off the field, and he wasn't letting the offense go with him at all. He said, we're staying out here, and we're picking this one up. That's some leadership right there.
Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down.
Dude, this Barclay guy is fucking crazy.
All the way down to the 23-yard line. 13 yards as the Vikings pick up the first down. Consecutive plays now for that offensive line created a lot of space.
And we've seen the confidence rise, haven't we? It borders on arrogance now, and that's that good arrogance, believing you can run the football whenever you get good and ready.
Now a throw here.
Oh, that's fun.
Heck of a broken tackle, but only able to work this down near the 23.
Oh, it's time to give a little credit there to the defense. They played that very well because it was a drag route. And he ran a little
we got more yards if we got
to
fucking break the tackle.
The field, He was hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line.
Exactly,
but once he made the catch, nowhere to turn upfield and gain any yardage.
From the 23, here's a second down and 9. Looking to throw. Bolden.
Yeah, and he's gonna get the animation. That's, I gotta leave the outside. Now he's just only coming out and fucking.
And it keeps 6 points off the board. After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on 3rd and 9.
Yeah, I know, I saw that.
Bolden. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And they will touch him down, but not before he gets the first. It's a pickup of 15 and a fresh set of downs.
A very important third down conversion right there, because when you're trailing and find yourself this deep in enemy territory, the kicker's not even part of your thought process. You got to make it.
Touchdown, Vikings! Jordan Addison, his second touchdown of the game, his 3rd on the year. And the Vikings are an extra point away from evening this one up. Point after, right down the middle. And that is going to tie our game as we approach halftime. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. And he'll very wisely take a knee here as they'll bring this one out to the 25 on the touchback. About set to get this drive started. The Green Bay offense at the line. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You can never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
They had the run for no gain. Now they'll try again from the 25 on 2nd and 10. Looking to throw. Cooper flushed out right. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30. They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also 3rd down. Out of the gun. They'll look to throw. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield, complete. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as they stop it with 19 seconds to go in half number one.
I'm not sure that that was necessarily a safety valve or a check down throw on 3rd down. Sometimes just try and find the open guy and get him the ball. He did exactly that and found a way to pick up a 1st down.
Cooper on 1st and 10. Quick hitter here, it's complete. Now the Packers going to go ahead and use the 2nd of their timeouts. So that means they're down to 1 remaining here as we head toward halftime.
And what a nice example there of a tight end doing exactly what he needs to do. How about how he worked his way to the outside, made sure he secured the catch, and then anything after that, we count that as a bonus. And indeed, he gets enough for the 1st down.
Ready. 2 1st downs have him up near midfield now on 1st and 10. To throw. Cooper. He's going to go deep for Beasley. And this is incomplete. Oh, he looked like he had a pretty good line on that one. That would have been a big play, but he could not pull it in.
Oh, I don't know if he's sensing contact to come or what, but that's a ball he'd love to have back. That could have gone for big yardage, but it just didn't want to stay in his hands. That's a tough break.
Now a 2nd and 10.
throw again. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Well, the great coach has said football is really a simple game. Rush theirs, protect yours. And he's talking about those guys throwing the football. In this situation, the rush won, hitting the quarterback and forcing him into an incompletion.
Now play number 7 of the drive as they're looking at a 3rd and 10.
19, Tiger.
They'll run out of the gun with Moss. And oh, he sheds a tackle. Now he's got some space. And he's going to have the Packers first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. 2 quarters down. 2 still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number 3 alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. And ready to get the party started for the second half. It was an even first half, all tied on the scoreboard. And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line. The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. It's a tied football game here. What do you think, Charles, the message was at halftime?
Well, I think that they probably just looked at things and said, we're fortunate that this is a tied game. No need to panic. No need to change a whole lot. We didn't play anything close to our best in the first half, so we don't have to go out and win one for the Gipper. Let's just go out and play our best football and win one for us.
Now we've got movement up front, and I think this is going to be on Minnesota. And that false start penalty certainly not helping their cause here. 2nd down and long. Looking to throw. Bolden. Oh, that's into a sea of bodies, and it's intercepted. And this return is going to be halted right around the 28-yard line. So opening drive interception to begin this second half.
And just think about the time you spent in the locker room going over what you expected to do in the second half. Not the way they saw it, not the way they drew it up. You find out this is something that you can't just edit, right? There's no rewrite here. This is live, and now they've got to find a way out of this hole.
Moss on the give up the middle. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, Packers. A great effort there. His first rushing touchdown of the year. And the Packers take the first turnover on defense and convert it into 6 points. So this game tied at the half, but we are tied no more. A touchdown there on the opening sequence of this 3rd quarter.
And what a great drive put together by their offensive coordinator. He had a plan, and they executed it almost to perfection, coming right out of the locker room. Now they're feeling good about their chances here in the second half.
Extra point by Curry, up and good. Leads now 21-14.
Left, right, or smell.
Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. So now, Charles, this drive, maybe a touch more important, trying to erase the memory of that interception they had the last time out.
Yeah, and everyone goes through this because even the best in the game, you're going to have games where it just doesn't go right for you, and interceptions result. So, frankly, to me, it's all about how you respond, not just the types of plays that you call, yourself, how you show your team that you're still with it, and how you continue to lead.
On a determined run there as he's going to take this all the way down near the 40. 97 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon.
A big hole there. How about him handling the point of attack? Just positioning himself so that run could go right off of his backside and deep into the secondary.
Right back to him on first down. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
Boy, where would these guys be without his performance on the ground? That puts him over 100 yards now for the afternoon, and I tell you, he seems to be getting stronger as the day goes along.
And he'll be out of bounds as he gets it down to the 30 there. A gain of five, good enough for the first down.
Well, you know they had a third down play on standby just in case, but he says no need with that carry. Runs like that will continually earn him more work in this and future contests.
Running game working, they'll stick with it on first down. And now off to the races, down the right side. Touchdown, Vikings. A great play there. 30 yards.
This guy pass commits every single play. I've never had blocking like this in my life. I have two running backs over 100 yards, less than 10 carries. My O-line sucks.
Into a good one here. 21 all the score as the kick's away. And no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And their lead has evaporated in this third quarter. It's tied once more as they begin with a first and 10. And not much to speak of. Call it a one-yard gain up to the 26.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
The last play got just a yard. Here's second and 9 from the 26. Back to throw. Cooper. He finds his receiver, Watson. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. He had the touchdown earlier. This one's going to get him a first down.
I'll tell you what, a lot of those mid-range throws have been available because sometimes teams get too concerned about the deep ball and they leave too much space in front of them. And these guys have been taking advantage so far.
Play clock at 4, we're going to get a timeout called. It's just their first, so 2 remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. Here's a give to Moss out of the shotgun. And slow going there as he'll only get a yard, maybe, up to the 41.
No doubt about it. A really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
Well, a nice throw here, right side. He hauls it in. It's a big play there for Green Bay. 42 yards. And now they'll audible to something else. First down, Jan, at the 17-yard line.
Right there.
On the give, this is Moss. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. What a difference a play makes. A huge step forward and now a small step back as he loses a yard or two.
But that's not an easy play for a defensive end because most of his responsibility has him getting upfield and working. But how about his vision to see where the play was going? Crashed down inside and tackled him for a loss.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
And those two just haven't been in sync thus far. They've done a nice job against him, but still, with his talent, you would expect them to have more completions this game.
A field goal would get them the lead, but that's not what they're shooting for as they come up on third down. On the RPO, that's complete right side. And the Packers are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And they'll take this into the end zone for a Green Bay touchdown. Taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Packers have taken the lead. He had the option to hand that football off. I think it's safe to say that he made the right decision. That was a heck of a run.
It certainly was, and when you mention the option, most people think the quarterback's not going to keep the ball. You know, in the NFL, that's usually not the recipe for being around too long. So when you do keep it, it often surprises the heck out of a defense.
Touchdown, here's Koo to kick off.
My fucking controller died on the kickoff. Oh my god, bro.
About ready to get this next drive underway. Well, certainly they'd rather have the scenario they had last time. Now, Charles, remember, they had the short field. They took it in the end zone. Now this is going to have to be a longer, more sustained drive if they want to get points.
Yeah, a little bit more of a quick strike opportunity last time by where they were on the field, and you're exactly right about that. But now, backed up a little bit, what's that old expression we love to use? Time to matriculate the ball down the field and try and do it again.
So a little more space to operate now. First and 10 from right around the 12. And they'll give him another shot here on the ground. And he'll take this one only up to about his 13-yard line. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
Well, Parker, I don't think it's any secret that any running back wants to be able to see a hole open so that he can gallop through it. But in this case, he had to slow down. There was really no hole there, and he took a big hit in order to get that 1 yard.
They work now on second and 9. One back in the backfield, he'll get the carry. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. No gain on the play there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a 3rd and 9 situation. Come to the line here, needing 9 yards to pick up the first. To throw on 3rd down, Bolden. And this pass broken up. And the contact.
And now Justin Jefferson's dropping.
And now 4th down. The Vikings send out their punter, standing about a yard deep in his own end zone.
I'm just chewing the rest of this shit. Take my fucking L.
Returnable
this guy
here
gets
from
a
the 38.
For being a cheesy bitch.
Well, nice job on the return there. 16 yards. And the Packers will have a short field to work with here as they take over 1st and 10. Lambeau Field, one of the best home field advantages in the NFL, no doubt. And they're a happy bunch here as the Packers lead 3rd quarter. On 1st down, they'll go to the ground attack. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up 2nd and 11.
I'll tell you what, this defense hasn't played its best, but they're still right in this football game. And if they keep making plays just like that, they're going to give their offense a chance.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a 2nd and 11. They'll try a little trickery here on the end around. There he goes, right side. Touchdown, Packers. Christian Watson with his 2nd touchdown of the afternoon.
Charles, his second touchdown of the ball game. He had the more standard receiving touchdown earlier. This time he finds the end zone in the run game.
Yeah, it's almost as if he said, well, that's how I normally do it. That's almost boring. Give me another opportunity. This time I'll use my legs only and get into the end zone.
Koo able to connect on the extra point. And the lead now up to 14. Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. Here just past the 20-yard line. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. These guys definitely hoping for a better showing than their last appearance. They couldn't really even move the football much beyond the shadows of their own goalposts, Charles. We'll see if they can get a better, more sustained drive going here.
Yeah, and every team that we ever talk to says the exact same thing. When you start a drive from that deep in your own territory, the goal is a minimum of at least two first downs, because even if you have to punt then, you change the field position, right? You flip the field a little bit. They didn't get that done. This time they want to string together a nice drive and help themselves out.
Three quarters in the books. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. From the 38 now, here's second down and three. Now a handoff running through the middle. And this will be a Vikings first down as he's got this up to the 45-yard line. And the offense moving quickly to the line. Right back to him on first down to about the 48-yard line.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here, because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last four plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, four plays in this drive, all four on the ground. To throw on second down, Bolden. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. And the Packers are in great shape here as they take over at the 46-yard line. Boy, so another interception, CD, and it feels like he's starting to unravel a little bit.
And as you would expect, still a work in progress here in his second season. He has to start ironing out some of these mistakes, though, because now his head coach, his offensive coaches, they have to evaluate whether you keep playing him and let him work through it, or you start thinking about going to his backup.
It's a pretty strong running there as he'll take this across the 50 and down to the 44. Back in the backfield, he'll get the carry. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. 4 yards on the pickup, it'll be second down. Now, I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely, you want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
Now a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete.
That's some good closing speed there defensively, because that looked open for a minute. That's great work with the ball in the air. Never gave up, converged on his man, and broke the play up.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. He's got his target. That's complete. And he gets us to the other side of midfield across the field.
Play action on 3rd and 13. That's fucking fun, man. Dude, why do I have to take an L on a game where he's not fucking following the rules? It just doesn't make fucking sense to me.
They work with the lead as they've got it 1st and 10.
Now and again this season, so I gotta fucking play it back.
And his rough afternoon continues. He's going nowhere again.
Dude hasn't followed a single fucking rule.
Okay, ready?
shit.
And that one off the mark behind him, incomplete.
Speed is the name of the game when it comes to RPOs, and sometimes
Raz and just go straight 2K.
Too quick, thus inaccurate, incomplete.
Over it.
The Packers on third down. They have been superb. 5 for 6 to this point. This is 3rd and 10. A throw there, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
I think it's safe to say that he's made some questionable decisions out there so far.
Now he's going for it up 14.
He's already been picked off in this game. Fourth down now, but he was fortunate on that one not to have another turnover on his ledger.
So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. Now it's Peterson. A very good punt, but a 16-yard return. And the Vikings will take over here, 1st and 10. The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. Their defense was able to force the punt. That's the good news. But this is still a 2-score game, and they need points
on this
drive.
Playing man coverage, playing the middle of the field.
They'll give him 4 yards there, and that's going to bring up 2nd down. Fourth quarter, every drive so critical, and you figure they only get one more shot after this, so a touchdown.
Oh, no, my internet's lagging.
It is, but you also have to think to yourself in play calling, don't hold anything back. Don't save it for the second touchdown. You got the first one for the second one to even matter.
I don't want to fucking do this.
Looking to throw on 2nd down. Bolden flush to his right.
Fucking hate this game.
Nothing open downfield, so he'll.
Ooh, I hate it.
And it's Mark Powell there. He's probably saying, I wish I would have done that one last drive instead of throwing the interception.
His force lost me the rest of the year.
So after the 2nd down incompletion, they'll come up now against a 3rd and 6. Now they try the right side.
That's
here.
So fucking true.
Be brought down at the 20.
Two guys block one person.
Well short of the first. It'll be a 2-yard gain, and that's going to make it 4th down.
Well, this was just simply excellent defense. On this 3rd down, they had to be alert for the possibility of a pass, but that didn't stop them at all from understanding what was going on when they decided to run the football, and they just swarmed and stopped them for almost no gain.
And he gets it to the 34, good enough for the first. And now they're in the hurry up. Throwing on 1st down, Bolden. Open man, he's got him, the tight end, Hockenson. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. A couple of 1st downs on the drive already. As they'll go from the 47 now on 1st down. They'll roll him out right. Going back to the same well, it's Hockenson again.
And the Warriors are ass.
Take this from 147-yard line to the other. A gain of 6. You got the big lead defensively. Willing to give them that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle them after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
And they'll run on the inside handoff. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42. On 1st and 10.
The ball
comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Well, they've been back on the heels a little bit here on this drive, but a chance to exhale just a little bit there with incompletion on 1st down. Now they have to gear up, try and get 2 more stops and escape this drive.
2nd and 10. Now a handoff up the middle. Michaels. And some room to work. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. On 1st down, Bolden. Touchdown! TJ Hockenson from 19 yards away. And the Vikings have made it a 1-score game again here in the 4th.
Extra point attempt to follow here. And that'll cut the lead down now to a touchdown. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. The return man down to a knee, and this will come out to the 25-yard line. About set to get this drive started, the Green Bay offense at the line. And with that last touchdown, I mean, we're set up for a good finish here. Some things to consider, Charles. Obviously, it's a very close game. You're in the fourth quarter. Defensively, they've got all three timeouts in their back pocket.
So the chess match really ramps up, doesn't it? Because in these situations, what do? Do you run the ball and kill the clock here? Or do you try and bury them with another score? And how about defensively? Do you use your timeouts as well as opportunity? Or wait till you hit the two-minute warning? So there's a lot going into this one. Let's see how each side goes about their strategy. And this is an absolutely big third down that's been set up here, partner. And there's no other way to put it. The defense has to get a stop here if they have any hopes of winning this game.
Pastor, you said big third down. I'd put the word big in capital letters here. This is third and two, maybe the biggest play in this football game. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. And his defense here going to burn their second timeout. But you can also factor in another timeout that they'll get when the clock stops at the two-minute warning. And not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And I think this defense knew what was coming as he is smothered behind the line.
Brings up second and 12 at the 38-yard line.
So it's Packer football here as we welcome you back. They've got a second down now as they search for a way to get this one to the finish line. Play at this point in the game.
Gotta give him points for the attempt, but there's just a wave of pressure there. A host of people in the area. Evades a few, but couldn't evade all of them.
So two plays with only negative yardage to show, and now it's third and 16. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. He's going to go deep for Beasley. It's caught inside the 25. And it's a Packers touchdown. A big play there. 66 yards. And the Packers use the big play to extend their fourth quarter lead. He put quite a bit of air underneath that touchdown pass. Of course, we knew that he had the strong arm.
That part was easy. You can see that throughout his college career. But what you want to know about a rookie is, when the pressure's on, can you throw with touch? He just did right there. And boy, it was pretty.
Extra point by Cooper. Up and good. And a lead now up to 14. Following the touchdown, here's Cooper to kick off. Taken down inside the 10.